As Vlahovic is on the verge of leaving a team which goes by the name of Juventus, a team where he signed this year in January. He has not even spent close to 2 years. It will be like 11 months and some days for him at Juventus. Then he is really destined to go somewhere else to either prolong his career. Chelsea have come in through and really said, we might need you to come on and really get the job done. Chelsea are really acting as a very good footballing club because they are on the verge of signing David Datro Fofana in January, the Ivorian that plays for Molde. And obviously, Endrick from Brazil has been announced as a new Real Madrid player, but he is going to join them when he hits 18 years of age. Welcome to Rokani Media Football. How are you guys? And where are you watching us from? I go by the names of Rokan David. Smash the like button, comment and share. If at all you're watching us for the very first time, lower right bottom corner, that's the place to be. Smash the black button that has over the subscribe. After, hit the notification bell, whenever you get notified every time I upload a video onto this channel. Today morning, before I forget, Rokan David is my name. Let's get into this. Today we've had a story coming in from Corey Dello Sport, telling us that Chelsea are ready to make serious attempt to sign Dusan Vlahovic from Juventus, who may be forced to sell their striker after the recent legal issues at the club. Now, people will come out and say, why is Juventus trying to sell a player they spent close to £63 million on when he was leaving Fiorentina to their club and Arsenal was in the need of this striker? The striker snubbed them and said, all right, I'm going to a team known as Juventus. Now, there are lots of things happening at Juventus. Remember, the entire board resigned and the CEO is now in charge of Juventus, meaning that there are things that are not really going well at Juventus. But let me show you what Jacobs Ben has for us as far as this trouble at Juventus is concerned. And he hints of Chelsea again in his story that Vlahovic might be linked to a side known as Chelsea. He posted on the 14th of December that he has been told there is a very real possibility Dusan Vlahovic will leave Juventus in 2023. A January exit is not being ruled out by those close to him. Several top European clubs are in touch with his agent, including Chelsea, although nothing particularly advanced at this point. Now, why is Chelsea in for this deal? Chelsea had Broja as a backup striker for Aubameyang, and they're still looking for another striker just to eat that they save their season, because their season is looking ugly and they really want to work out something or craft out something to see to it that it pans out in the positivity of what Todd Boehly wants, because Todd Boehly has gone ahead to do lots of things at Chelsea and they've not paid positive results. And if I told you what Todd Boehly would like to go on and really try to extend and inject money and get in players. One of the signings they've made is Nkunku, though he's going to arrive in the summer, meaning that they need a center forward after the injury of Broja, and Broja has been ruled out of the season totally. It's not like Gabriel Jesus, who got an injury, and after he got an injury he underwent a surgery, and we might see him return on the 1st of November, sorry, on the 1st of February or the 1st of March. Broja is out, and Chelsea are afraid Graham Potter has put his board under pressure to get him strikers. One of those available on the market is Vlahovic, a player that is really good at scoring goals. To me, he's a finished article, proven. If you create those chances, he'll go on and really put those balls at the back of the net. But the big question will always be, is Chelsea going to master the way Graham Potter wants to play in the next 6 months? Because it looks like it's going to be a long journey, and that long journey is going to go on and really cost every center forward at Chelsea, because chances are not coming in to be created to the strikers that they're supposed to be coming in. Now, the longevity of the players to fit and get used to the philosophy of Graham Potter will come out and give the success, or will determine the success of every player that is going to play as a center forward at Chelsea. Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang getting him chances, he would bury them in the back of the net. That's it. But they even brought Raheem Sterling, who was really pampering goals at Man City like nothing. He's not scoring. Do you know why? The chances that are being created are not enough. Every center forward should get on average 3 clear-cut chances per game. And on 3, if at all he can convert 1 or 2, then he can be so much clinical. That is something that Chelsea is eyeing. But Vlahovic to Chelsea, put your eye onto it. It might happen, and they are in for Vlahovic. But that means if at all Vlahovic comes in through and Nkunku comes in the summer, Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang might find himself into the same situation he was in at Barcelona, and obviously he'll have to look for another club to go on and play for the game of football. Is Newcastle going to come in and take him? Because Newcastle is Mr. Moneybags. They can take Aubameyang, but looks like Chelsea are really having a huge plan. And obviously on that huge plan, there is another player that is a striker who's still a teenager that we're gonna hate to sign. And Fabrizio Romano has gonna hate to let us know that Chelsea would sign David Datro Fofana in January, with the plan still remaining to bring Christopher Nkunku to the club in the summer. Many clubs wanted Fofana, but Chelsea were faster. That's what Fabrizio Romano told us. Chelsea are on the verge of signing Maldi striker David Datro. A full agreement is in place between the clubs, over 10 million euros plus fee, with personal terms still being discussed with Fofana. Guys, if you know where the game of football is going, then Chelsea is on the right track, because they are trying to do deals before even the summer comes to place. Deals that are viable, that can get executed, they are really sanctioned and obviously done and dusted. That's what a competent team should be doing. And Chelsea is doing this when they've not even announced their new technical director or sporting director. One of those has not been announced, and they are nearly going to announce him. But it's evident that he's the man behind all these deals that Chelsea is doing in a very speedy mode. Thanks to Todd Boehly. I know at a point X, Todd Boehly will get payoffs. Chelsea fans are grieved. I've grieved with him for chasing or sacking Thomas Tuchel and bringing in Graham Potter. But if at all you know where the game of football is going next, it is shifting from that programmatic style of management and sacking managers that the predecessor of Todd Boehly, I don't know, he used to do, into a way of developing a philosophy that is planned by a sporting director that will fit the club even when a manager leaves, meaning that philosophy outlives every manager at the club, and it is a perfect fit for every player that they're going to sign, meaning that's like drawing a plan for the system of play and demarcating and identifying which type of players you need in that system. That's what Chelsea is doing. That's why you see to it that they went in for Chukwuemeka from Aston Villa. They went in for, is it Hutchinson from Arsenal, the young one. They're now bringing in this 18-year-old known as Fofana. Very many clubs have been really looking at him. And him being at Molde, I believe Molde has an eye of that because of Haaland's recent performance, and very many teams are really going back knowing that maybe Molde is really good at really grooming these teenagers that are really good at scoring in goals. And that's a benefit of being a club that is really good at bringing in young talent that goes ahead to go on and outlive the prospects of very many other people like Haaland. So Haaland was at Molde, and obviously he left for RB Salzburg, then Borussia Dortmund, and now at Man City. And his father's confirmed that he's going to go out and prove in every league that can go out and really bang in goals, meaning that at Man City, he'll leave Man City in the next 1 or 2 years. But remember, Julian Alves is going to have to announce himself as one of those that is untouchable in scoring goals. You've seen him at the World Cup, 4 goals in how many games of the World Cup? 6. And he's having one more game to play in the final to see to it that he really uses that. So Chelsea is really doing great, according to me. And obviously, Fofana coming in throughout that age is something that every Chelsea fan would go on and feel good at. Now, lastly, Endrick, the 16-year-old, is a player that Madrid has come out and announced that they've signed the player. Obviously, the deal reaches up to 75 million euros, and he's going to join them in 2020. 24. Why is Madrid doing this? They are doing this simply because they don't want to lose out on another player like they did on Messi and Neymar. For Neymar's case, Madrid was really up there. Barcelona came in through with a big bag of money and they bought the player. They hijacked him from Real Madrid. Madrid felt badly and now here they are. They want to go all out and sign a player who is still young because they don't want to lose out on the battle. And this has happened like this because Barcelona is really in a very difficult financial situation. And they can't come out and match the level at which Madrid is spending because Madrid has just sold Casemiro at £70 million. They still have some money in their bags. They are also performing well in the Champions League and they have some good Champions League money with them because they earn close to €130 million from the Champions League and UEFA, and that means they made some good amount of money. So they have money to spend. Endrick, the 16-year-old, has been confirmed as a Madrid player. He's going to join Real Madrid in 2024 when he turns 18. That's what is happening for that 16-year-old player. Real Madrid has broken the bank. £65 million upfront fee plus add-ons guaranteed. Guy is 16, 17, but he is really heavy. Heavy, and I believe Brazil have gotten another center forward who is going to go ahead and really score very many goals for them. So guys, thank you very much for watching in. Tell me what you think about Vlahovic to sign for Chelsea in January and Chelsea going in for another Fofana, because remember they already bought a Fofana from Leicester at £75 million and this one is way much cheaper. They've gotten him at €10 million. What are your thoughts on those two deals and Endrick signing in for a club known as Real Madrid? Announcement made today. All your reactions in the comment section below. Thank you for watching in. I'm out. See you later, and may the Almighty Lord bless you abundantly.